This story begins exactly 1 week after the events of the movie Wakanda Forever. It's been over a year since King T'Challa has passed. Shuri, now with closure, sends the Avengers a message that she will be having a small public memorial service for the king. Nakia and little Prince T'Challa are hosting the memorial with Princess Shuri. As you all know, most of our heroes are held up keeping the streets clean, free from crime. So only those listed as follow were able to make it. The first Avengers to arrive together were Bucky and the new Captain America, Sam Wilson. They both shake everyone's hand, and Bucky is the first one to talk. Your brother, the King, was a very kind man, allowing me to seek refuge and to get medical help from all of the Wakandan scientists. I will never forget what he did for me. Sam Wilson now speaks. I've only been Captain America for a few months now, and being a leader is no easy task, but King T'Challa made it look effortlessly. The next guests to arrive are Bruce Banner and War Machine. There also appears to be someone way in the back underneath the trees. This person will remain unknown right now. Bruce and War Machine talk about how nice and noble King T'Challa was for helping them when Thanos was attacking. Bruce then mentions the very funny time when him and the King first met and Bruce bowed to him, only for King T'Challa to say, "We don't do that here." The last person to step out was none other than old man Steve Rogers. He reminisces about the time him and King T'Challa were running together to face Thanos' army. Steve then says how King T'Challa was the only one to ever beat him in a foot race. This seems to be the last of everyone, right? But remember, there is still one more person way in the back, standing underneath the trees. This person finally speaks. "I'm very sorry for your loss." As this person starts walking up to the front, his spider symbol on his suit is the first thing to stand out. Spider-Man, aka Peter Parker, is here at the memorial with his spider suit completely on. Spider-Man then says to Shuri, "I know this has been a very hard time for you. I too have lost loved ones recently, and it's not an easy process to go through. But maybe, Princess Shuri, we can uplift each other during our grieving process. And even maybe we have more in common than what it seems. Shuri then hugs Spider-Man, as this could be the beginning of a very strong friendship.
Lift me up, hold me down, keep me close, safe and sound, drowning in an endless sea, take some time and stay with me, keep me in the strength of your arms, keep me safe, safe and sound.
In my culture, death, it's not the end. It's more of a stepping off point. You reach out with both hands and Bast and Sekhmet. They lead you into the green veld where you can run forever.